Our second speaker is Lucia Meoni, a leading scholar of Italian tapestry. Since 1986, Ms. Meoni has held a special position cataloging the city of Florence's vast tapestry collection. Her research has yielded and continues to yield substantial new information on Florentine tapestry manufacture from the 16th to the 18th centuries. In 1998, Ms. Meoni published the first volume of her comprehensive study of the Medici tapestry collection. The second volume followed in 2007, and the third is in progress. Ms. Meoni has also written numerous articles, essays, and catalogs for exhibitions in Italy and abroad. Her insightful scholarship was also included in the publications for the Met's Tapestry of the Renaissance and Tapestry in the Baroque shows, and she contributed an essay to the Kuker catalog. Today, Ms. Meoni will talk about the Italian influence on Kuker's designs. I'm very pleased to welcome Lucia Meoni.
Good morning. The exhibition dedicated to Peter Kuker van Alstad has provided an occasion to expand upon previous scholars' insights and attribute to this Flemish painter the designs of some important series of tapestries which belong to the 1540s. Among these is the set of the seven creation tapestries, which Cosimo I de' Medici and his wife, Eleonora di Toledo, acquired on June 13, 1551, from Jan van der Valle, son of Peter, well-known merchant of Antwerp, who sold many important tapestries to the Habsburgs and other European rulers. The presence of initials on each tapestry provides evidence that the creation series was woven by a group of famous tapestry makers in Brussels. Sometimes fragmentary, but nevertheless identifiable, these monograms are those of Jan de Kempenaer, Jan van Tiegen, and Frans Gittels. No drawings, cartoons, or documents are known for the creation, but stylistic comparisons with the Kuker's secure works of the 1530s and 40s are decisive and convincing. In God Accuses Adam and Eve, its face, its frame of thick blonde hair, the shape of the eyes, and the pointed chin is strikingly similar to that of Medea in The Triumph of the Last from the Seven Deadly Sins series, designed in 1530s. The sins, the life of St. Paul and the story of Joshua, represent the most secure works attribute to Kuker as a tapestry designer. However, his face is also typical of the Kuker's wider and well-known physiognomic repertoire. The drawing in the Uffizi, depicting Christ as a fount of mercy, reveals the extent of Italian influence on Kuker's style. It is one of the two sheets attributed to him in a list of works belonging to Cardinal Leopoldo de' Medici, drawn up by the Florentine historian Filippo Baldinucci in 1673, and is still accepted as by the Flemish master with a date of 1533-35. Striking comparison can be made between Adam and Eve in the drawing and the silhouettes of Eve plucking the forbidden fruit in the original scene and the muscular body of Adam in Adam Names of the Animals, as well as between God the Father, enveloped in beautiful red and gold robes in the expulsion from Eden, and God the Father's similar representation in the same sheet. Links with the Kuker's works of the 1540s are even more pronounced. In the well-documented Lisbon triptych of 1540-45, depicting the descent from the cross, the faces, bodies, and movements of Christ in the interior left wing and of Mary Magdalene in the central panel reveal remarkable parallels with the figures of Adam and Eve in the original scene. If Georges Malier author of the most complete monograph on Cooke before the present exhibition catalogue, recognized the causal links between some of the creation figures and those of the triptych, but he placed this tapestry series among works of an uncertain attribution. A relationship is also evident between the Florentine series and Poesia and the story of the Turnus and Pomona, which belong to the 1540s as well, and represent a shift from the crowded and complex compositions of the series of the scenes, Life of St. Paul and Story of Joshua, from the previous decade. One particularly significant example is found in the Sacrifice of Polixena from the Poesia of 1547-48. The foreground figures of Adam and Eve in the original scene display features and body types that are closely related to those of Neoptolemus and Polixena on the tomb of Achilles in the Poesia. In the Creation, as well as Vertumnus and Pomona and Poesia, Cooke generates a splendid synthesis of elements which are clearly of Italian influence, together with the style, the narrative language, and the taste for decoration of the Flemish artistic culture. According to traditions of narration in Flemish art, the protagonists reappear in consecutive episodes across the same composition in God Leads Adam into Eden, the original scene, and God Accuses Adam and Eve. In the Medici Creation series, the luminous low-rise line and the classical sculpture-like nudity of figures that dominate the landscape and move fluid in an ample space display an understanding of Italian Renaissance design, as elaborated by the generation of so-called Romanizing painters, among whom Peter Cooke van Aalst is considered a forerunner. On the other hand, the naturalistic interpretation of the large landscape of ground derives from Flemish artistic culture. In the Poesia series, as in the Creation, the characters in the foreground stand in a large scenic landscape. This type of compositional staging was developed by Raphael in studio in their decorations of the walls of the Vatican Loggia in 1519, and subsequently reused by Raphael's collaborators, notably Giulio Romano and Perino del Vaga. Giulio Romano used this device in Mantua in 1527-28 for the scenes in the walls of the Camera de' Venti and the Camera delle Aquile in Palazzo Te, and again in 1536-40 in the Sala di Troia in Palazzo Ducale, where he articulated it with more complexity. Perino del Vaga would also go on to use the same compositional scheme from the Vatican Loggia, especially for his frescoes, lunettes, in various rooms of Palazzo Fassolo, today known as Palazzo del Principe in Genoa, painted for Admiral Andrea Doria, such as in the Sala delle Metamorfosi. While the landscapes of Cooke's Poesia reveal this Italian influence, on the other hand, the episodes depicting the background, which represent the moments before and after the principal narrative, are fully Flemish in style. It has been suggested that Cooke's principal protagonist in the Poesia revealed the influence of Peperino's sophisticated style in the seven tapestries depicting the loves of Jupiter. Now lost, the set was woven in Brussels for Andrea Doria in the mid-1530s. A surviving drawing from the series showing Jupiter and Juno was recently acquired by the Metropolitan Museum of Art. Moreover, the gigantic figure types in Perrino's Louvre cartoon for Jupiter and Danae recall Michelangelo. It has been noted that in The Rape of Ganymede, Cooke derived his design from Michael Cox's Love of Jupiter, which was engraved by Cornelis Boss in 1545. This depiction of Ganymede between the talons of the eagle stems from Michelangelo's drawing for Tommaso de Cavalieri. In the Artumnus Empomona series, designed by Cooke around 1544, loggias consisting of heavy overhanging vegetation are supported by caryatids. They recall the illusionistic scenery of verdant porticos and caryatids, which open up to reveal wide spacious landscapes frescoed by Dosso Dossi and his brother Battista for the Duke Francesco Maria della Rovere at the Villa Imperiale in Pesaro in 1529-30. Together with his collaborators, Camillo Filippi and Bernardino Bellone, Battista Dossi elaborated Dosso's inventive motif of a human camp plant figure from the Pesaro frescoes in the Gardens Tapestry series, woven for Ercole II d'Est in Ferrara by Jean Carquet. Here, however, Battista and his assistants framed the portico of entwined vegetation within a colonnade architrave, a motif which Cooke then used for some of the architectural scenery in the Vertumnus Empomona series. It has been proposed that the caryatids were probably inspired by the tapestry replica of the frescoes and staccos in the gallery of Francis I, woven in Fontainebleau between 1540 and 1547, after designs by Rosso Fiorentino and Francesco Primaticcio. The reworked structure of the gardens, clearly derived from Italian models, is resolved, however, with an exaltation of the decorative, a typically Flemish trait. Nevertheless, Italian influences are particularly evident in the creation, so much so that some scholars have suggested that the tapestry were actually commissioned by Cosimo I de' Medici, who bought the series in 1551. The creation vividly recalls the fresco scenes of Genesis in the first vault of a Vatican loggia, decorated by Raphael in studio in 1519. In Cooke's creation, God has the same naturalism and lightness of movement seen in the loggia paintings by Giulio Romano, Giovan Francesco Penni, and Guillaume de Marsillia. However, in the tapestries, the faces of God, finely touched and framed by beautiful red and gold garments, seem to acquire even more expressive power with a strong sense of majesty. The birds gliding through the air with the widespread wings, the elephant, lion, a unicorn, in Adam names the animals, are all reminiscent of Loggia's creation of the animals by Giovanni da Udine and Pellegrino da Modena. Even the borders of the creation tapestries, with grotesques in the manner of the bronze low reliefs woven in yellow gold and dark ochre on a pinkish background, consciously adapt the pictorial structures of the loggia, in which friezes painted in fresco to imitate bronze run below the main scene. In these borders, the exuberant figurative decoration of flowers and animals, real imagery, as well as a Bacchic procession, display on intricate ferronerie and cuir, is notable as one of the earliest examples of Flemish grotesques, locally called rolwerk. Along with the engraver Cornelis Boss and the Antwerp designer, architect, and sculptor Cornelis Floris, Cooke must be considered one of the originators of this type of grotesque. This style was inspired by the paintings in Nero's Domus Aurea, rediscovered in 1480. After initial experimentation in the late 15th and early 16th centuries, the grotesque format was codified into an ornamental vocabulary in Raphael's works in Vatican loggias and in the Villa Madama. The style was then dispersed throughout Italy by his collaborators after the sack of Rome in 1527. Some examples of the grotesque which predate Raphael's Rome projects, more populated with the human and mythological figures which are entwined with the phytomorphic and zoomorphic elements, bear more significant relation to the Flemish interpretation of the grotesques and the border of the creation. The poses of Adam in the original scene and Eve in God Accuses Adam and Eve are similar to those in a drawing of the Rijksmuseum in Amsterdam after Baldassarre Peruzzi's fresco Golden Vault in the Palazzo della Cancelleria in Rome, finished around 1521. Cooke likely executed this drawing towards the end of the 1530s. It exhibits probable retouching by Peter Paul Rubens, to whom the inscription on the sheet is attributed. Cooke's stylistic trajectory and artistic activity appear to have been oriented towards the conception of the new style introduced by Raphael, who explored the potential offered by different means of expression, such as tapestry making or printmaking. The novelty of this attitude lay in the view that a different medium could give rise to the new interpretations of the traditional stories in accordance with the mannerist pursuit of the variety through form, material, and expressive means to produce accurate details and innovations or marvels. Nevertheless, Cooke was not indifferent to Michelangelo's interpretative approach to the human body. The complex twist of the figures referred to one of Buonarroti's fundamental concepts, according to which the artist, when freed from the bounds of the natural representation, can recreate and interpret the body to display artifice. The squatting Eve in Cooke's God Accuses Adam and Eve recall Michelangelo's Eve in the Temptation on the Sistine Chapel ceiling. The figure of Eve also relates to an engraving after Michelangelo's lost painting of Leda and the Swan, reproduced by Cornelis Bos, Cooke's acquaintance in Antwerp. The Leda recalls the marble sculpture of night carved by Michelangelo for the tomb of Giuliano de' Medici in the new sacristy of San Lorenzo in Florence. I would suggest that during Cooke's travels in Italy, he visited Florence, where a well-established community of Flemish immigrants had been resident since the previous century. I was astonished to find that in Cooke's expulsion, the blonde, curly-haired cherub guarding the tree of life has the same stunning gaze and parted lips as the youth supporting Christ in Jacopo da Pontormo's deposition in Santa Felicita in Florence, completed in 1528. He must have seen it in person, as no early prints of it exist. Similarities can also be observed between the female figures of Sandro Botticelli, such as the celebrated paintings of Birth of Venus and Primavera, located in the Medician Villa di Castello in the early 16th century. The profiles, the hairstyles, and the distant gazes of Eve in the creation have much in common with the figure of Hora, who holds out the cloak for Venus, and with the central figure of the three Graces. It seems plausible that Cook studied Botticelli's female types. They are long-limbed figures with graceful gestures that become suspended as poses. The stance and silhouette of the female nude in the Calumny of Apelles, painted by Sandro Botticelli in 1494-97 for Antonio Segni, the papal banker, resembled that of Vive plucking the forbidden fruit in the original scene. Other versions of the nude Eve in the same original scene tapestry and in the creation of Eve call to mind the veiled bodies of the three graces in the Primavera. I'm inclined also to suggest some conjunctions with the Botticelli's profiles and female nudes in the series of Vertunnus and Pomona. In Cook's Poesia, the male figures of Perseus and Icarus hovering in the air above the landscape also call to my mind the figures of the Zephyrus and Chloris who fly across the sea from which Venus is born. However, the naturalistic background of Flemish artists is a far cry from Botticelli's idealized kingdom. Perhaps Cuke was attracted to the works of Botticelli because he knew of this Florentine master role as a designer of a tapestry cartoons. In Florence, there may have remained better evidence of this activity during the 16th century. Today, traces of his tapestry designing only survive in two drawings, one at the Uffizi and one in Oxford, both for a Pala de Tapestry, now conserved in a private collection in France. Woven in an orphan workshop, perhaps Flemish or more likely French, after 1491, it was commissioned by Abbot Guy de Baudray while he was the commendator of the Abbey of Saint-Martin-au-Bois. I have already noted how some details of a creation hint at the Cook's interest in Giulio Romano's frescoes in Mantua, to which other scholars in the present exhibition catalog have identified credible references in other works of the Flemish artist, not only in textile. His glimpsed three-quarter face in the background in the original scene is very similar in the roundness, in the shape of the eyes, and the fleshy lips to the Uffizi cartoon fragment of the hermaphroditic head drawn by Giulio Romano for the Allocuzio, frescoed in the Sala di Costantino in the Vatican in 1523-24. God's face in the creation of Adam also reveals Cook's observation of the face of Jupiter, frescoed by Giulio Romano, in the center of a vault in the Sala dei Giganti, depicting the fall of the giants in Palazzo Te in Mantua. In the creation series, the focus is on the actions of the figures, rather than of the settings which had so fascinated Raphael in his design for the stanze of the Vatican. Cook's scenes have more in common with the Giulio Romano's works in Mantua, such as his Lecon frescoes of 1536-40 in the Sala di Troia of Palazzo Ducale, which expressively reinterprets ancient Roman reliefs with intensely dramatic figure and vibrant movements. In particular, the Lacon human chain is recalled in the creation of Eve, redirecting dramatic attention away from the setting and towards the foreground protagonist. In conclusion, while these comparisons depend upon the timing of the Cook's travels in Italy, which remains under discussion, so precise are Cook's visual quotations of the Vatican frescoes and other Italian works that these seem to have been based on something more vivid than just memories, already a decade old, or drawings circulating in the north. Beyond any doubt is the sharp change in Peter Cook Van Alst cartoon production during the 1540s. In this splendid tapestry series, the Italian influence becomes ever more apparent, rendered nonetheless in a manner which is fully bound to the Flemish figurative styles. Thank you.